Commodores Biography. 1. Biography. Renowned for the R&B hits Just to Be Close to You, Easy, and Brick House, to name but a few, Commodores were one of the top bands during their long tenure at Motown. The group is credited with 7 number one songs and a host of other top 10 hits on the Billboard charts, and their vast catalog includes more than 50 albums. 2. Start. The members of Commodores, all of whom attended Tuskegee Institute in Alabama, came together as a result of two groups disbanding, the Mystics and the Jays. Initially formed to simply play music as a pastime and to meet girls, the lineup consisted of William King, trumpet, Thomas McClary, guitar, Ronald Lopred, bass, Walter Clyde Orange, drums, Lionel Richie, saxophone, and Milan Williams, keyboards. The members nearly went stir-crazy trying to pick a name for the group, but with no success. As a last resort, Orange gave King a dictionary and told him to pick a name. That name was the Commodores. With Clyde Orange the only learned musician in the group, Commodores began spreading their music throughout their base, which included Tuskegee, Montgomery, and Birmingham, Alabama. 3. Success. After success securing dates in their own backyard, the band ventured to New York City for a gig at Small's Paradise. Told, in so many words by the club owner, that their sound was not happening, the self-contained band was nevertheless called back to the club to fill in for a last-minute cancellation. That night the Tuskegee alumni performed before a standing-room-only crowd, most of which were friends and family of the band. Unaware of the planned crowd, the owner booked the band for 2 more weeks. For opening tour. Commodore's long association with Motown began as a result of a tour opening for the Jackson 5. That opportunity occurred in 1971, when the group auditioned in New York City for an unknown yet high-profile gig. 2 weeks later, they made their first appearance in the prized support slot, and didn't give it up for more than 2 years. Their excellent shows naturally led to a deal with Motown, and they debuted with the up-tempo instrumental dance cut Machine Gun. Written by Milan Williams, its top 10 outing gave the group immediate attention. It was followed by the top 20 single I Feel Sanctified, which led to their third single and first number one record in Slippery When Wet. Inside of 17 weeks, the septet was rocking the airwaves with their brand of southern funk, spiced with an animated vocal delivery courtesy of Lionel Richie and Clyde Orange. In September of 1976, they released Just to Be Close to You, their second number one single and a number 7 pop hit. The top 10 hit Fancy Dancer followed, and then came Easy. Different from their other tunes, Easy was very serene and not nearly as soulful or funky as the band's other tunes. Nonetheless, it claimed the number one spot on the charts, and it paved the way for the style of ballads the group became known for. One exception to the ballad-heavy approach was Brick House, the song that soon became the group's anthem. The arrangement and candid vocal lead by Clyde Orange was complemented by the evenly saturated percussive and rhythmic attack, and it cracked the top 10 at number 4. 2 consecutive number 1 singles would follow, the dance cut 2 Hot Ta Trot and the placid number 3 Times a Lady. And then there was still, the last number 1 for the group with Richie as a member. In 1981, Richie recorded Endless Love with Diana Ross. The song peaked at number 1 for 7 and 9 weeks, respectively, on the Billboard R&B and pop charts. Its success was a prelude to what Richie enjoyed upon his 1982 exit from the group. 5. Absence. In the absence of Richie, the group promptly courted tenor J.D. Nicholas, formerly of Heatwave, and ended up recording their biggest hit. Penned by Clyde Orange, Night Shift paid tribute to the late soul singers Marvin Gaye and Jackie Wilson. For 4 consecutive weeks it topped the charts, and it also won the group their only Grammy. Commodores finally left Motown in 1985. Consequently, the group signed with Polydor the same year and had another swing at the top 10 with Goin' to the Bank. During the 90s, the band was reduced to a core of 3, Orange, King, and Nicholas. The threesome were nearly as active as they'd ever been, performing around the world and managing their own label, Commodore Records. Research, Vitor Hugo Lizard Leonard. Hello friend, I am a big music lover, and because I thought that without music I would be nothing in this life, I created this channel. The soul is the root of music, and in my humble view, everything we hear today of good music is related to the soul. If you liked it, leave your like and subscribe to the channel of this force so that new content like this can be produced. Thank you very much.